Hi students, I am Dr. Badrinath and today's topic is CMR Shopping Mall. CMR Shopping Mall very popular in both Telugu states, that is Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, we know very well. CMR, Centrally Acting Muscle Relaxants. See the logic here, CMR, Centrally Acting Muscle Relaxant. These drugs relaxes the muscles, okay, but directly does not act on the muscle. That is the logic here. That's it, acts centrally. It acts on the centrally, on CNS, central nervous system, and the spinal cord. But all the skeletal muscle relaxants, it relaxes. These are the medications which do not act on the muscles directly. It acts on the centrally. Switch is somewhere and the light is somewhere. So if you put on the switch here, the light will glow here. The same logic here, okay? Centrally acting muscle relaxants, right? Okay. And this, we can call it as reversely also, muscle relaxants, centrally acting, okay? Centrally acting, right? Okay. And mainly all these medications are using for the back pain, mainly all muscle spasms, all muscle spasms, wherever you have a skeletal muscle, all muscle, if you want to relax it, muscle spasms, we can call it as hardness of the muscle will be increased. Toughness of the muscle, rigidity of the muscles is increased. In such a cases, you have to reduce the muscle stiffness. Okay, muscle has to be relaxed, smooth muscle. Okay, especially back pain is due to the stiffness of the muscle, back pain that we know very well. So mainly back pain, you can keep in your mind here, muscle spasms, back pain. These are the two important words what you have to keep in your mind. See here, this is the area, all the muscles will be get harder. Okay, right. So the drugs medications acts on the spinal cord and central nervous system. That's why it is called a centrally acting. See here, back pain is a keyword, muscle spasm is a keyword here, you have to keep in your mind. And here directly I will give one wonderful drug that is called as a baclofen, but however it is having a lot of side effects also. That is another part we will discuss. Baclofen, that is the name of the generic name, not the thing. And Liorisal, it is the brand name. It is a Novartis company. It's available in the form of a tablet. I don't know who designed this generic name, baclofen, baclopain. So it is using for the back pain. Baclo, low means in or low. Baclo, baclofen means pain. See this pronunciation, baclofen, baclopain, like that. And this baclofen acts on GABA B receptors. GABA A, GABA B are there, C also there. GABA B receptor, baclofen. That's why here the keyword is B for B. B means baclofen, B for GABA B. So B for B, like that you can keep in your mind. So GABA B facilitator. GABA B agonists, it helps the GABA, like that you can remember. Okay, B for B, B helping for the B, agonists, right? Like that. Yeah, we are studying a subject of pharmacology 1 theory for B pharmacy students and all medical and paramedical students. Okay, and this is your syllabus. In the syllabus we can see here, the sedative and hypnotics I have already uploaded. Centrally acting muscle relaxants. So that is the topic what we are discussing now. So there is a three types of muscles we know very well. Cardiac muscle is having a separate properties like automaticity, rhythmicity. These are the two important cities have the properties of the cardiac muscle. Automaticity, rhythmicity. And skeletal muscle, we know very that it is all the muscles which are attached to the skeletal system are called as a, this is skeletal system, we know very well. These are the muscles, all skeletal muscles and smooth muscles. Smooth muscles are like this. So small intestine, stomach, large intestine, these are the smooth muscle, doesn't attach to the skeletal system. That point you have to keep in your mind. And what is the speciality of among the three? What is the skeletal system? Skeletal muscle property means flexibility and rigidity. Muscles have become very flexible. At the same time, muscles can become a high rigidity. That is two properties it shows. Two properties it shows. Flexibility, rigidity. one time, sometimes it becomes a tough, sometimes it become a loose. That is a speciality. That is also due to the depend. That also due to the depends upon the neurotransmitters present in the brain, CNS, central nervous system. So it, behavior is depends upon the neurotransmitters. Okay. So this is a speciality like that. Here you can see that that is a. Whereas this property, flexibility and rigidity, you cannot see here. You can't see rigidity here because that's why it's called as a smooth. Okay. Here also you cannot see the toughness as well. Yeah, so CMR reduces the skeletal muscle tone. That is a main property. Muscle tone, muscle rigidity, muscle hardness, all these things will be reduced by the CMR and acts selectively on cerebrospinal act. Name itself indicates centrally acting central nervous system. Cerebrospinal act. This is a cerebrum. This is a spinal cord. This is vertebral column. Vertebral column is belongs to skeletal system. Whereas a spinal cord, this is a spinal cord. This spinal cord is a neurosystem. It is a neurons. Whereas a vertebral column, it is belongs to skeletal system. Okay. Spinal cord is present in at the center of the vertebral column. Okay. At center one hole will be there. So acts selectively on cerebrospinal axis. Okay. Right? No effect on peripheral neuromuscular junction. There is a two types of say muscle relaxants are there. Centrally acting and peripherally acting. Peripherally acting are, it acts on the near to the muscle, at muscular, neuromuscular junctions, whereas peripherally muscle relaxant, whereas centrally muscle relaxant, no way it is related to the muscles. Okay, so no effect on peripheral neuromuscular junctions, no effect on muscle fibers directly, act centrally without altering the consciousness. It acts centrally only, but there is no consciousness. You will think that patient will lose the consciousness because it acts on centrally. No, patient will not lose any consciousness. Places patient is always alert, even though he is using a medication. Okay, and selectively depresses. What is the mechanism of action? Is that this is the main mechanism of action of all CMR? Selectively depresses the spinal and supraspinal. This is a spinal, and this part is supraspinal. Supraspinal. Polysynaptic reflexes, okay, and it depresses the RF. RF means reticular formation. Reticular formation is always wakefulness. Always you are awaking. Reticular formation means you are awake. Here it depresses the reticular formation. Okay, so reduction in the wakefulness, but to a only lesser extent only. Don't think that. It wakefulness will be reduced, but not like a sedative or sleepy. No, like that. Always you are alert only. Okay. All CMR have some sedative, not completely. Some little sedation property, but not equal to sedatives. Okay. Yeah. Here you can see the important difference between the centrally acting muscle relaxants and peripherally acting muscle relaxants. See, peripherally acting muscle relaxants, it is already completed and uploaded the video. It is already available. See here, that's why this is also called as neuromuscular blockers. So this video is available under the neuromuscular blockers in my pharmacology one playlist. Okay, see, peripherally acting muscle relaxant, it acts near to the muscle at the junction of the neuron and muscle. Okay, it causes the muscle paralysis. Paralysis or weakening of the muscle, voluntary movements will lost. You can lose your work. Whereas here it decreases the muscle tone without reducing voluntary power. You have your own voluntary power, okay, but muscles are relaxed. Okay. Selectively inhibit the polysynaptic, so far what we have studied in the last one, polysynaptic reflexes. Reflex means the signaling. Polysynaptic reflexes in the CNS, it blocks the neuromuscular junction. Whereas this acts on cerebrospinal. Okay, it causes some CNS depression, little, not too much, very little, very almost negligible. Here, no effect on the central nervous system. Okay, that's why this is called peripheral. Given orally, sometimes parenterally. Here, practically always given IV injection only, practically. Okay, used in the chronic spastic condition and acute muscle spasms like a tetanus. This is mainly using for the peripherally acting muscle relaxation, mainly for a surgical operation. They will give all neuromuscular blockers, peripherally acting one, very excellent for muscle, if you want to do an operation, you have to make the muscle smooth. Otherwise, you can't do the operation. You can't do, you can't cut the muscle because muscle is very hard. In such a case, you have to give a neuromuscular blockers, that is peripheral acting muscle relaxant, make the muscle to relax. So it becomes smooth, then you can cut it. So I have clearly explained in the one. And classification, you can see mainly four classes are there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Mefenicin congeners, mefenicin, carisoprodol, chlorzoxazone, very important. Chlorzoxazone, mefenicin, very important. And chlormizanon, methocarbamol, okay. And benzodiazepines, we know very well, diazepam and others, diazepam family. Benzodiazepine, here itself is there, diazepam, okay. And the GABA mimetic, baclofen, I have already told, it's a friend of GABA, GABA B especially, it is an agonist. And thioglucocorticoid, but baclofen is main important here. And centrally, alpha-2 agonist, tizanidine. These are the main classes you have to keep in your mind. Four are there, centrally acting. All are centrally acting only. Okay? Yeah. We will see the mefenicin. One by one, we will see. Mefenicin, it is also called as a intermucinal neuronal blocking agent. Intermucinal. Why we are calling this is intermucinal neuronal? In the examination, number of times it will be asked. What is an intermucinal neuron blocking agent, mefenicin? Because its primary site of action is there in the spinal cord, intermucinal neuron. It is one of the junction, intermucinal neuron, which modulates the muscle tone. This intermucinal neuron is responsible for the muscle tone. Okay? So, you have to block it. If you want to block it, you give them mefenicin. So it blocks the this one, intermucinal neuron. So automatically muscle tone will be reduced. Clinically, orally not used. See here, this is very important. That's why here I kept it. Clinically, orally and injections also not used. See here. Why clinic orally not used? Because of marked gastric irritation. That is in the examination, definitely they will ask in the competitive examination, why mefenicin is not used orally? High gastric irritation. Even though you are injections, there is a problem of thrombopleptis and hemolysis, breakdown of the RBC, fall in the blood pressure. All these are the problems. This is also asked in the examination. Why can't we use mefenicin in the form of injection? Why can't we use in the form of tablets? Very important. Only ointments, gels are available here. Relaxyl, because this muscle relaxant, you know, Relaxyl. This is very interesting name also they will put like that. Relaxyl, because it connects easily to the doctor. See here, mefenicin. So this you have to keep in your mind, Relaxyl. It is available only in the form of a, okay. And carisoprodol, it is available in the tablet. It's one of the favorable muscle relaxant. It is also, okay, widely available. It has a sedative property, analgesic property. This is also very important. For which drug is having a sedative, analgesic, antipyretic, anticholinergic properties, means carisoprodol. It is available in the form of tablets. See here, very big sheet is available. Okay, in the brown color, carisoprodol. Yeah, very my favorite drug. This is a chlorzoxazone painkiller. This combination is available. See here, chlorzoxazone tablet under the name of Mobijox. Chlorzoxazone. Joxo. Here, see, chlorzox. Okay, Mobijox. Mobile. You will move like a horse. Mobility. Mobijox. Like that, they will design the name. Because it is having a very good antipyretic. That is a paracetamol and diclofenac. Three very big weapons are there. 1, 2, 3. Three sides of painkiller, no fever, no pain. Immediately you can prescribe. But if pain is more, immediately you will get a relief. If you use the combination of diclofenac, paracetamol, and chlorzoxazone. Very three big weapons are there. Okay, one big racket is there, one jet is there, one flight is there. Three are there here. Okay, you will become a horse like a movement, right? It is also available in the form of tablet. And chlormizanon. Chlormizanon. It has anti-anxiety hypnotic actions. Hypnotic action. Okay. It is a prescribed in the tension, muscle tension states, and our tension is there, muscle spasm is there. In such a case, they will give a Dolobac. Dolobac. That is a chlormizanon. No pain, no this one. Okay. So prescribed in your mental tension condition state with increased muscle tone. Once your tones are hard, and tension. In such a case, Dolobac is the number one. Example brand is Dolobac tablets. Here you can see the Dolobac tablets. White color, very beautiful patch case is available. Robinox, Mithacarbamol. Mithacarbamol. It is a less sedative, longer acting. Okay. And orally used in reflex muscle spasm and chronic neurological diseases. Very long time neurological disorder they will give you. And muscle spasms also used in muscle spasms are there. You can see the dictionary or refer what is muscle spasm. You will get number of meanings. Okay. So it is having a less sedation and longer acting than the mefenicin. It is better. Okay. And used for orthopedic procedures, operation in that, and tetanus also, not tinnitus. Tinnitus means ringing in the ear sound. This is tetanus. IV injections can done without producing a thrombophlebitis. I have already told you, thrombophlebitis and hemolysis are the main biggest of the mefenicin, disadvantages of the mefenicin. Whereas here it overcomes the thrombophlebitis and hemolysis. IV injections also available. Here, that is a main difference between mefenicin and you side by side, you can compare it and you can read it. Robijax and diazepam, benzodiazepine family, we know that it is a GABA facilitator, enhances the GABA. GABA, we know very well, it prevents the excitation of the neuron. So you will become always cool. If your mind is full of GABA, you will become a cool because your neurons will not be excited. GABA prevents the excitement of your neuron. Okay, muscle tone is reduced here due to its action on the supraspinal cord. It has a muscle relaxant and sedation effective. Valium 5 is very popular, very biggest brand by the very popular company, Roche number one company. Valium 5, Valium 10 also available. This is Valium 5, Valium 10 also available. That is a 10 mg. Okay, so no gastric irritation. This is a gastric friendly. Okay, it has a muscle relaxants and sedation for sleeping and so. Diazepam is number one. It has an anti-convulsant property also, diazepam. Yeah, baclofen, it is an analog of GABA, selective GABA B receptor agonist. So code is B for B here. It does not affect the chlorine conductance. Chlorine will be conducted in the GABA receptor, we know very well. But however, this baclofen acts on the GABA B, but it does not affect the chlorine conductance. Hence, its actions are not antagonized by the bicuclin. Very important bit. Very, 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 very important bit. Baclofen, bicuclin. Baclofen, bicuclin. Number of times. Baclofen actions cannot be antagonized. Cannot be antagonized by the bicuclin. Because chlorine conductions will not be interfered by the baclofen. That is the main important part. And it produces the muscle weakness. That is the main one of the thing, muscle weakness and less sedation than the diazepam. Okay. And preferred in muscle spasticity, ALS. Okay. Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, multiple sclerosis, spinal injury, flexor spasm. Okay. It is ineffective in the stroke, brain stroke, cerebral palsy, rheumatic. It is not at all effective. That point you have to keep in your mind, and a traumatic muscle spasm and Parkinsonism, it is not effective. Orally well absorbed, that's why the tablets are available. Orally well absorbed, but lesser extent, the half-life is 3 to 4 hours only. So every 4 to 6 hours you have to take. That's why 3 doses we have to mention here per day. And these are the side effects. Number of times it was appeared in the competitive examination. What are the main side effects of the baclofen? Baclofen side effects are the drowsiness. See here, drowsy. See, sloppy, so sloppy, sleepy, so sleepy, the drowsiness here, you can see, mental confusion, this is a mental confusion, you can see, weakness, muscle weakness, that is also one of the disadvantages. See, 4 disadvantages are there. Ataxia, means crosswalking, he will not walk properly, this is called a disease of ataxia. These are the 4 main side effects are there. At the same time, after long time use of the baclofen for a period of 6 months or 1 year, if you remove it suddenly, if you remove the tablets suddenly, it leads to tachycardia. Tachycardia means speed. Tachy. Okay. Bradycardia means broad, very slow. Bradycardia. Tachy means tachy. Okay. Right. Tachycardia and seizures. You looks like a seizures. and hallucination. See here, these are the three important. After sudden long after long term chronic use, don't remove the tablet suddenly. You tell them to take alternative day. Later, after certain period, 2 days once, 3 days once, like that, you have to slowly withdraw. You have to withdraw. At all of a sudden, you stop tablet completely means hallucinations will come, tachycardia will come, seizures will come. These are the first three, and these are the four. These are the side effects. These are the symptoms after sudden removal of the tablet after chronic use. Yeah, and last one. Tizanidine, it is an alpha 2 adrenergic agonist. Very, 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 very important bit. Okay, only one and only drug is there. Okay, tizanidine. It also facilitates the inhibitory neurotransmitter like a glycine. This is a glycine friendly. Glycine GLABA are friends. Okay, this is a glycine friendly. It facilitates the inhibitory neurotransmitter of a glycine, it an amino acid and spinal neuron. Inhibits the polysyn, first point slide only, polysynaptic reflexes, results in a decreased muscle tone and frequency of the muscle spasm, okay, without reducing the muscle strength. So muscle strength remain constant here, okay, absorbed orally and having a lesser half-life, 2 to 3 hours. That's why nearly 4 to 5 doses you have to be take for one. Okay, and these are the side effects of tizanidine. Dryness side effects, drowsiness of the dry mouth, first one. Dry mouth, drowsiness, insomnia, in sleeplessness. So she's waking. See how she's eyes are open like this, even in the moon also, So there is a no sleepy, insomnia and hallucinations. This is a hallucination. You'll feel that you have third eye by seeing you in the mirror. The hallucinations. Okay, these are the main four side effects of the tizanidine. Okay. So these are the overall uses of the CMR. Same muscle, for muscle, acute muscle spasms, okay, torticollis, lumbago, backache, neuralgia, anxiety and tension of the muscle, increased tone of the muscle and spastic neurologic diseases, tetanus, okay, electroconvulsion therapy, orthopedic manipulations and all. And this is the last one. If you want, you can be take down the screenshots, all the cardiac muscle properties, skeletal muscle properties, and smooth muscle properties. Okay, if you want, you can take a screenshot. Okay, so I will end my session here. You can keep watching on my playlists. Go to playlist, there you can find all videos subject wise. You will find, okay.